So tell me right now, where are we?
Right now, we can confirm that we do have one twin-engine Cessna that has crashed into a residential occupancy here in Biddeford. We do know that we have one confirmed victim in the aircraft. At the present time, there is some speculation as to where the what the aircraft is, where it was coming from, but to be perfectly honest and frank, we can't determine that because of the condition of the aircraft. There are no discerning markings, there are no plates on it, anything that we can find that we're able to confirm. So that's probably very well going to take place tomorrow.
Tell me, you know, a lot of times people say, oh, what's the number on the tail? Tell me why that's not...
We have no tail. For the most part, from probably the fourth seat back in the aircraft, there is no aircraft. So we really don't have anything to go on that would give us any kind of identifying features or markings for the aircraft.
So a decent, if it has four seats, I mean, a decent sized plane, at least not just like the...
Absolutely. Like I say, it's a twin-engine Cessna. We're looking at least probably six or eight seats. FAA is on the scene. National Transportation Safety Board is notified and on their way. Medical Examiner's Office is en route. That's who we're waiting for. Once we meet up with the Medical Examiner, do some preliminaries on the situation that we have with the aircraft in the building, our office will begin extrication of the victim from the aircraft.
You know, obviously, I know you don't want to speculate on where it was coming and going. That's fair. But, I mean, there are trees on top of the roof, and there are trees gone there. So, I mean, at least it looks like it was going in this direction, right?
My understanding is, and certainly the chief can confirm this, his line of flight apparently appears right now to be en route to the airport.
Yes.
Fire alarm from
that. You want to get chief, or are you good? You guys have another question?
I'm good.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Chief, you want to...
Maybe we'll just talk
maybe about how big of a fire, you know, it was when you guys...
Yeah, for you guys to handle, I think.
Is everyone still good? Yeah. Chief, if you could just say and spell your name, please, and give us your title.
Chief Joseph Warren, W-A-R-R-E-N.
Okay. Biddeford, obviously.
Biddeford.
just tell me, when you guys got on scene, what was it like?
When the first arriving crew got on scene, he reported that they had a structure fire fully involved.
I mean, tell me about, you know, obviously planes don't normally crash into buildings, and I know you train for the stuff like this, but, you know, tell me what complicates it in terms of fuel in the plane, that gets it going, what's the...
Well, what complicates it the most is the fact that you don't know about the fuel in the plane. You don't know what type of fuel cells the tank has. Some carry the fuel in the wing, some carry it in pods at the ends of the wings. If you look at the building, there is a wing with a pod hanging over, which was very concerning to me because it was leaking and what was leaking out of it was burning. So, you know, you have an explosion hazard right there that, you know, you have to contend with as well as the building that's completely involved.
Now, a lot of, you know, witnesses or people who live in the neighborhood said they heard an explosion. Whether that was an explosion or whether it was just a large plane crashing into a house, I mean, is it hard to tell at this point? Did you see any signs that something blew up? Or
I really can't tell you. I wasn't here. I just know... From listening to what some of my people said, they heard, you know, a large bang. It sounded like the tailgate of a dump truck when it empties. When it closes, that's what it sounded like.
And at this point, you know, I mean, still some concern that there might be fire somewhere, that something could reignite. Tell me about that. What are you doing right now?
Well, the fire is predominantly out. There are still probably some hot spots. Because of the nature of waiting for everyone to do their investigations, we really can't get in there and tear the building apart to make sure that everything's out until the fire marshal is done, the FAA is done, and, you know, once these people are done their job, then we can go in and finish ours.
What are you thinking in terms of when is the body going to be removed? Is that tonight or tomorrow, you think?
That's the fire marshal's call.
I'm assuming it'll be sometime tonight, but that's their call.
Thanks, Chief. I appreciate it.
Thank you. So you-